Today we are going to start with the detailed study of organic compound, that is nitric acid. So first of all, you should know that what actually is the molecular formula for nitric acid. So it is HNO3. So the molecular formula for nitric acid is HNO3. So obviously, what elements it possess? It possess hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. So let us look for the, as we know the molecular formula now. So let us look for the molecular mass now. So if we just want to calculate the molecular mass, you know that we have to just add their atomic masses accordingly, the number of atoms present in it, right? So as there is one hydrogen atom, so the mass of one atom of hydrogen is 1. As we can see, one nitrogen and mass of one atom of nitrogen is 14. And as there are 3 oxygen atoms present, so obviously we are going to multiply the atomic mass of one oxygen atom with 3, right? So it is 3 into 16. So what, when we solve it, what comes out to be? It comes out to be 63. So the molecular mass for HNO3 is 63. Now, we should be curious to know its structure also, right? So what is its structure actually? It is like this. So what kind of bonds you get to see in it? So there is, you can say, a double bond made between nitrogen and oxygen atom, and there is a single bond between N and O and a single bond between O and H. And you get to see one different type of bond, and you know that what this bond is actually. It is a coordinate bond, right? So there is one coordinate bond present in it, there is one double bond which is present in it, and there are 2 single bonds which are present in this molecule. And you know that what is coordinate bond, but still for your convenience, I'll just repeat the definition for you. So coordinate bond is actually formed, it is a type of bond actually in which the the shared pair comes from the one atom. That means it is formed between 2 atoms in which one has the shared pair, or you can say the one has the lone pair, another is deficient of electron. So the complete shared pair is donated by a single atom to the another one, so which is represented as arrow, right? So the arrow, the point from which the arrow starts indicate that it possesses the lone pair, right? And this point in which we are just making the direction of the arrow, it points that the lone pair is contributed by this N towards this O. So we can say the structure, when we talk about the structure of HNO3, it is like this, right, as stated below, above. Right. So there is a double bond, there is a coordinate bond, and there are 2 single covalent bonds present in it. Now, after doing it, you should want to know that where do we get nitrogen, right? So we get nitrogen in the environment, we get in air, water, everywhere, right? Almost everywhere. And the composition just varies. And how it occurs in nature? So it occurs in nature, when we talk about its occurrence, so it occurs in nature in free form as well as in combined form. So it occurs in nature in free form as well as in combined form, right? So first of all, you would like to know that where it occurs free in nature. So that means where we find this nitric acid free in nature. So for example, I'm just telling you, we can find the nitric acid in a free form present in a rainwater, right? So see how it occurs in a free form in rainwater. So what happens? So I'm just writing here because we are I'll be telling you that where we get this free form, and we get it in rainwater, right? So how it occur actually, how the nitric acid presents becomes possible in case of rainwater. So what happens? You know that when there is lightning, so what happens? The N2 of air, that means the N2 which is already present in air, it combines with oxygen to form the nitric oxide. Then what happens, this nitric oxide form, I'll write the name also, nitric oxide. This nitric oxide form is however not stable, right? So what it does, it actually combines with the atmospheric oxygen. So that means this nitric oxide combines with more oxygen present in air and forms the nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide is somehow stable in nature, right? So then this nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide, combines with the water, that means the rain water, right? And in presence of the atmospheric oxygen, it get to form HNO3. So this is how the HNO3 occur in this thing, the free form in the rain water. And you know, this is something, the constituent of the acid rain. And you all are aware of the harmful effects, aspects, that how the acid rain is formed and or what adverse effect it can do for us, right? So this is how you should know that how the acid rain is formed, or in which for like how you get the free nitrogen available in the rainwater. Now when we talk of its combined form, as I told you, that it occurs in nature in free form as well as in combined form. So we are just going to see that where it occurs in a combined form. So when we talk of its combined form, so what happens, it occurs, it exists as many salts, right? For example, the common salt, so not the common salt, I'm just, whenever I say a common salt, this doesn't mean that always it is NaCl, it is a table salt, right? The specific name for it is table salt. But when I'm talking about the salts here, it means that I'm talking about the any other salt. Common means the commonly occurrence, right? So what kind of salts, for example, I'm writing with the common name, we have petre. Petre is actually NaNO3, right? And when we talk about nitre, you know what, nitre is the common name for potassium nitrate. As petre is the common name for sodium nitrate, nitre is the common name for the potassium nitrate. Likewise, we have calcium nitrate also, which exists in nature. There is no common name for calcium nitrate. See, there are few times when you have common names for certain salts or any other substance, and so sometimes we just use a chemical name. There is no common name. So it is not specific that every substance is going to have the common name as well as the chemical name. So likewise, as I told you, that these sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate has a common name. That is why I have written here, right? Otherwise, that like the calcium nitrate doesn't have such common name, so I'm not writing any common name. We'll be using its chemical name. So you can see that how it occurs in nature, it occurs in free form as well as in a combined form, right? So now we are just going to start with its preparation, because you'll be curious to know that how this nitric acid can be prepared in lab as well as in industries.